Welcome. The next tutorial on electric power system is the medium transmission lines. So we will solve some problems on medium transmission line. So the first problem is, if you have the generalized circuit constant of a three-phase 220 kV rated voltage, medium length transmission lines are given. So the ABCD parameters of a medium transmission length line is given. Now, if the load at the receiving end, so the information about the load is being given, so the load is 50 megawatt at 220 kV. So this is the information of the load at a power factor of 0.9 lagging. So the power factor is 0.9 lagging. Then magnitude of the line to line sending and voltage, what should be? So you have to find the value of VS line. So what is the value of the sending and voltage of the line quantity? Now the first point that you have to take consideration here is, since the system is three phase, all the data that are being given, that is the load data, they are three phase equivalent. You have to convert that into single phase equivalent in order to solve the problem. Then you have to transfer that into again the three phase quantity. So solve the problem in single phase and then convert it into three phase quantities. So here the power 50 megawatt is corresponding to three phase power. The voltage 220 kV is corresponding to the line voltage. So this is the line voltage, this is the three phase power, and this is the power factor of the load. So let us see. Now the power received by the load is 50 megawatt. So what is the current at the receiving end? So if you have a load where the power is 50 megawatt, so what is the current flowing here, IR? Now we know that the power is basically root 3 times the line voltage, line current and cos phi. So here we can find out what is the value of the line current, because the power is being given as 50 megawatt, that is the three phase power, and the line voltage is already given as 220 kV. So what is the value of the line current, that is the receiving end current? So root 3 VR IR cos phi, put the values of the power. So this is the power formula. So here from where you can find out the current. So 50 megawatt and 220 kV, that we have to substitute to find out the current at the receiving end. So the current at the receiving end is 145.79 ampere. Next, the power factor is given to be 0.9. It means the phi value, that is the angle between voltage and current, is 25.84. So the receiving end current in terms of the vector is 145.79, which we have calculated is the magnitude, and 25.84 is the angle, because we have taken the reference is to be the VR. So VR is taken as the reference, which is at 0 degree. So here it will be at 25.84. Now the value of VS we can calculate it from the ABCD parameter. We know that the sending end voltage, sending end current is related with the receiving end voltage and receiving end current with the ABCD parameter. So the sending end voltage we can get as AVR plus BIR, where the parameters A and B are already given, and VR is given to you and IR we have calculated. So this is the value of the sending end voltage. Then this value is corresponding to single phase. This value is corresponding to single phase because all calculations we are doing in single phase. However, the question is asked, what is line to line sending end? So we know that the line voltage is equal to root 3 times the phase voltage. So multiplied the root 3 with the magnitude of 133.246, the angle will remain the same. So you'll get an answer of 230.78 as the magnitude of the three phase line voltage with an angle of 7.77. So the magnitude is 230.78, and that is your answer for the sending end voltage. The next problem that we are going to solve is, given the ABCD parameters of a 220 kV line, if the sending end voltage of the line for a given load delivered at the nominal voltage is 240 kV, so 240 kV means it is the sending end voltage, the percentage voltage regulation of the line. So you have to find what is the percentage voltage regulation of the line if the ABCD parameters are given and the sending end voltage is given. So the voltage regulation of the line is given by the formula voltage at no load minus voltage at full load by voltage at full load into 100, whereas we take the reference as the receiving end. So corresponding to the receiving end, we are trying to find out the voltage from no load to full load condition. And we know that the sending end voltage is basically A times receiving end voltage plus B times receiving end current, and for no load condition your receiving end current is zero. So receiving end current will be zero. Then because here we have to find the no load condition. So no load condition your receiving end current will be zero. Then the voltage at the no load condition at the receiving end would be equal to, because this will become equal to zero, so Vs by A. We have been given the value of the sending end voltage, we have been given the value of the parameter A, so we can easily find out what is the voltage at the no load condition. Percentage voltage regulation, then we can calculate as the voltage of the no load, that is we have put it here, and minus voltage of the receiving end at full load condition, that is given in the question, divided by the reference as full load voltage into 100. So 16% we are getting the voltage regulation of the line. So this is problem number 2. Problem number 3, here we have been given the ABCD parameter of a 3-phase overhead transmission line at no load condition. No load condition means the receiving end current to be zero. A shunt inductive reactor, shunt means parallel, so a shunt inductive reactor means you have to connect a reactor in the line, is connected at the receiving end. So at the receiving end you will connect a reactor to limit the receiving end voltage to be equal to the sending end voltage. So the condition is given as sending end voltage is equal to receiving end voltage. So what is the ohmic value of this reactor? So what is the value of X of the reactor that we have to consider? So the case given is sending end voltage is equal to receiving end voltage. Now, since the ABCD parameters are given, and it has been given the sending end voltage is receiving end voltage under no load condition, your receiving end current is zero, and here you have been connected a reactor, so at the receiving end the reactor is connected. So the new ABCD parameter, so this is your new ABCD parameter, is equal to the old ABCD parameter without the reactor multiplied with a reactor ABCD. Okay, so having known that, the voltage at the sending end will be equal to the new A parameter that we are going to obtain from here multiplied with the voltage at the receiving end under open loop condition. So the value of A will be equal to 1, because the sending end and receiving end current is equal. This is the case that we have been given. So your sending end and receiving end current is equal. It means your this parameter, new parameter A, would be equal to 1. So if A is equal to 1, then A plus BY will be equal to 1, because this is equal to your voltage. Okay, so here you have been given, if you split this, A multiplied with 1 plus B multiplied with Y, so A plus BY is equal to A1. So A1 you are having given the value of 1, and Y you have to find out, and then so Y is basically A divided by A 0.1, that is the value of the parameter A divided by the parameter of B. So after finding the value of Y, you can find out what is the impedance. So impedance is equal to 1 by admittance. So you have find out the impedance, and then the value of XL will be equal to 2000 ohms because R is 0. So the reactor that you are connecting at the receiving end, so it is XL value is equal to 2000 ohms. So in this way, we can find out, because if you have an old system and you have been connected with a new system, then your parameters together will become a new ABCD parameter. So new ABCD parameter you can indicate by A dash, B dash, C dash and D dash. So this way we can solve the problem. Next problem, problem number 4, is basically 110 kV 3 phase transmission line whose ABCD parameters are given. If no load voltage of the transmission line is 110 kV, then what is the power loss under no load condition? So no load condition means your receiving end current is 0. You have to find out the power loss under the no load condition for the particular system. So let us see. So the system, as you know, that from three phase we will be converting to single phase to solve it, then the voltage at the receiving end was given to be 110 kV. We have to divide it with root 3, angle is 0 because we have taken the 0 as the reference, and line voltage is equal to root 3 times the phase voltage. So phase voltage would be equal to 1 by root 3 times the line voltage. Then since the receiving end current is 0, the sending end phase voltage will be equal to A times the receiving end phase voltage. So the parameter A is given, and A is, and receiving end voltage is this. We can find out the value of the sending end voltage phase, and the sending end current will be equal to C into B V of R phase. So we can get it. So this is corresponding to Vs Is, and it is equal to the ABCD parameter of the line, whereas the VR value will be there and IR would be 0. So this, when splitting, we can use this equation and this equation to find the voltage of the sending end and the current at the sending end. Then the power loss we can calculate at the no load condition as 3 times the sending end voltage, sending end current, and the cos of the angle between the voltage and the current. So that will give you 0.02 megawatt. So in this way we can calculate the no load power loss for a medium length transmission line when its ABCD parameters are given and the conditions are that the receiving end current is 0 under the no load condition. Problem number 5 we are going to solve. So here the line constant of a 200 kilometer, that is a medium length transmission line of a 3 phase 50 hertz, are given. So these are the ABCD parameters given. Sending end voltage is given to be 230 kV. So sending end voltage is given to be 230 kV. In the previous problem, receiving end voltage was given. Find the value of line charging current when the load is disconnected. So load disconnected means IR to be 0. You have to find out what is the charging current of the line. So the sending end voltage now we have to convert into per phase, that is 230 by root 3. And then the receiving end current is 0 because the load is disconnected. So the from ABCD parameters, we have a relation Vs is equal to a VR plus BIR, where IR is equal to 0. So it means that you can easily calculate the value of VR is equal to Vs by A, because your IR is equal to 0. Vs is already given, A is known to us, so you can find the value of VR. So VR is equal to Vs by A, we can find out the value of VR. After that, we can find the charging current IC as C into VR, because your IR is equal to 0. So C is known to us, VR is, we have calculated, so we can find out what is the charging current of the line. Next problem, problem number 6. Is a 3 phase 50 hertz overhead transmission line 100 kilometer, that is the medium length transmission line. The parameters are given to us, the resistance per kilometer per phase, inductive reactance per kilometer per phase, capacitive reactance per kilometer per phase. determine the sending and current, sending and voltage, sending and power factor, transmission efficiency when supplying a balanced load of 10,000 kilowatt 66 kV power factor. This. So the load information that is being given is corresponding to a three-phase load. You have to use the nominal T method to solve this problem. So the parameters are given. The difference between the previous problem and this problem is that the ABCD parameters are not given to us, rather than the parameters are given to us. So here it is the T model that we have been using. So this is equal to Z by 2, this is equal to Z by 2, and this is your admittance Y, and this is your load connected. This is the sending end voltage, this is the receiving end voltage, and this is the phasor diagram. So here, since it is Z by 2, all the parameters will be R by 2 and XL by 2. Here also R by 2 and XL by 2 will be there. However, this will be equal to C. Now, total resistance per phase, then since the length of the transmission line is 100 km and 0.1 is given, so multiplied, so total resistance would be 10 ohms. Total reactance multiplied with 100, 0.2, 20 ohms, and capacitive susceptance, we have to multiply Y, find out, so it is equal to this much Siemens. So in this way, we have find out the values of R, XL and Y. Now we can easily construct the T model, where this will be equal to Z by 2, this will be Z by 2, and this will be equal to Y. So Z by 2 means R plus JX divided by 2 parameter. So the receiving end voltage would be equal to 66,000 divided by root 3, because we have to convert it in single phase quantity. So this will be 38,105 volt. Then the current information, so this is the load we have. What is the current flowing here? IR. So we know that power is equal to root 3 VL IL cos phi. So using this formula, we can find the current IR. So power is given to be 10,000 kilowatt and 66 kV is given the voltage. So it is equal to 109 ampere. Cos phi R given to be 0.8, sine phi R will get 0.6. So the impedance of the line per phase is equal to Z is equal to 10 plus. So 10 is the resistance and 20 is the reactance. And then the receiving end voltage will be taken as the reference phasor. So VR, this angle will be equal to 0 this much. Then the receiving end current, you can take cos phi R minus psi phi R. So this is the receiving end current. We have find out the magnitude of the current and the angle. So the voltage across C, what is the voltage across C? So we can apply the KVL equation. So we can apply the KVL equation in this loop. So this is equal to Z by 2, this is equal to Z by 2, and here you have the Y, right? So what is the voltage across V1? You have to find out. So this will be equal to the receiving end voltage VR plus the drop here, voltage drop. So apply the KVL in this loop, apply the KVL in this loop to find out what is the voltage across the capacitor. So you'll get this much. Then the charging current IC, because this is the shunt parameter you have. So current is equal to voltage into admittance, where admittance is equal to J omega C. So that you can do to find out the charging current of the line. So the sending end current is equal to, so this is the KCL equation that you can apply, because the current is dividing into two parts. Current is dividing into two parts. So this is the current IC and this is the current IR. So what is the sending end current IS? So at this junction, you can apply the KCL. So IS is equal to IR plus IC. So the sending end current magnitude is coming to be 100 ampere with some angle minus 29.47. So sending and voltage, now you can find out, apply the KVL in the first loop. So you can apply the KVL here. So this is equal sending and voltage. This is your voltage across the capacitor V1 or VC, and this is the drop Z by 2. So apply the KVL here. So once apply the KVL, you will get this much sending and voltage. So once the sending and voltage is applied, so this voltage is corresponding to single phase multiply with root 3 to convert it into line voltage of the three-phase quantity. So after that, you have to obtain the value of theta 1 and theta 2. So what is the theta 1? Theta 1 is the angle between VR and VS. So the angle between the receiving end voltage and the angle between sending end voltage. The angle between receiving end and sending end, you'll get theta 1. And the angle between receiving end and sending end current, you'll get theta 2. So the value of phi S, that is the sending end power, angle between sending end voltage and sending end current, will be equal to theta 1 plus theta 2. So once we do that, we'll get 31.27 as the angle of phi s. So sending end power factor cos phi s will be equal to cos of the angle 31.27. So it is equal to 0.853. So sending end power will be equal to 3 times the sending end voltage, sending end current into the power factor. So you'll get 10273.1.105 kilowatt. So we have find out the sending end power. So the power delivered is 10,000 kilowatt, and then we can find out what is the transmission efficiency. So power output, that is at the receiving end, is 10,000 kilowatt, and this much power is basically at the sending end. So multiplied with 100, we'll get the efficiency of the line as 97.34%. So that's complete the solve problems on medium length transmission line. In the next tutorial, we are going to solve problems on long length transmission line. Thank you.